Welcome to another episode of the YouTube channel, Too Many Plugins. I'm your host, Alex. Today we're going to talk about an issue that is now plaguing the community of gamers. Is that a recent study has found out that 60% of games played in 2023 and 2024 were older games, and older games they're talking about most of them older, more than 6 years old. Everybody's throwing that only on the issue of that older games are better than new games, and I in a big part agree with that. Many older games are actually better than newer games, but there are also many new games that are really good also. The issue is not just the fact that older games are better than new games. That's not the only issue why 60% of gamers are playing games that are older than 6 years. This has a lot to do with another issue, and that is the price of hardware. Many people cannot afford a new computer. Modern games are very, very, very demanding. Prices of computer parts are still very, very high, especially graphics cards, but also motherboards are very expensive. Processors, not so much. And memory, it's pretty acceptable prices. And storage also, like SSDs and NVMEs, are in this moment still quite affordable. But they're also saying that in 2024, storage, so SSD and NVMe drives, can go up by 50%. So they have produced too much in the last couple of years, and now they stop producing, and they already saying, the producers of storage, that in 2024 the price is going to go up of storage. But the issue is this: it's a little bit the same as with Windows 11 adaption, which was very poor, is because if you want to run Windows 11, you need a computer that has 10th generation a processor in it, or a Ryzen 2, and a motherboard with UEFI BIOS, Secure Boot, and TPM, Trusted Platform Manager. So you need a very, very recent computer for that, and this is why the adaptation to Windows 11 has been so poor. Really poor, actually, if you look to adaptations to from Windows 10 and Windows 8 and 7, is because those ones didn't demand you to have the most recent hardware, you know. And in games, it's we are living in a time where the cheapest graphics card to go for €250-300, 180, and you cannot even play a game. And if you want to play a game on acceptable frame rates, you're paying €300-500. And if you want to play on very high details, in 4040p or in 4K, you're talking about graphics cards of $1,000 and $1,500 and stuff. So, you know, then not even talk about you need a lot of memory, you need a processor, you need a motherboard. Motherboards are very expensive. They are twice the prices before the COVID situation, you know. Only memory and storage is then quite payable. Even power supplies are expensive. What you now you have now cheap power supplies of $30 or $40, but they are completely garbage. And in the old times, for example, for $50 you bought a nice power supply, $50 or $60, and now those ones are already $80 to $100. So the prices of computer parts are very expensive, and this is a reason why people are also playing older games. And it's also a reason why many people haven't shifted to Windows 11, because they don't have the hardware to run it, you know. And that's the same as modern games, you know. Yeah, people look to the modern games, they're fantastic, but you look at the specifications over there, and there's even many times games that are for even designed for kids, but you need a €1,600 a computer to minimum run that, you know. So you know, that's the reason why 60% of the people are playing all the games, because they can't afford it, and their hardware, what they have, cannot run that on a decent frame rate, you know. And the same is then for the adaptation from Windows 11. Most people are just running Windows 10 is because they don't feel like buying a new computer just to run another operating system, which is even more intrusive and much more telemetry going on, and locks you down for everything, wants you to only use Microsoft products and Microsoft Edge, and even if you try to use another media player, and it is very difficult to do. And if you want to do different things on your computer, it's just all the time locking you out for that. It even just wants you to only use Microsoft Office, and not even LibreOffice or OpenOffice, the free versions, you know. And Windows 11 7 is very difficult to change things, you know, and they even all the time change it back after an update, you know. Then you change your Explorer and your media player, and it changes it back to Edge and to, you know, so and spying telemetry going on. People are not up to that, you know, and people just can't afford it also, you know, and that's a little bit, you look at Windows 11, yeah, it has a little bit more of a fancy desktop or something, but for the rest it performs exactly the same as Windows 10, or actually many times even Windows 10 performs a little bit better because it's less intrusive and less spying going on and telemetry, so, you know, and then games also, yeah, people look to the latest games, yeah, they're a little bit even higher detailed graphics, but they don't care, they prefer to play in a game that is a couple of years old, that has very close graphics, you know, and still very and not outdated graphics, but still for today really, really good. And they prefer to run that because they don't want or they can't afford a new computer, you know. And this is all a little bit to plant obsolescence also, you know, and that's not a very, what Windows 10 have done and what many modern video games do is they push the graphics so hard, and I've seen games like Forza Horizon 5 that was running perfectly on DirectX 11 graphics card that after one update it doesn't run on DirectX 11 graphics cards anymore, only on DirectX 12. Yet people bought the game that were forced to buy a new graphics card, and these are little deals that are being done even with Microsoft and with graphics card companies. They push certain technologies like RTX or going from DirectX 11 in DirectX 12 in a game where even in graphics it didn't really make any difference. That game looked almost or basically just as good in DirectX 11 as DirectX 12, only there were all of a sudden 4 million people who couldn't play the game anymore or needed to buy a new graphics card, you know. So this is all very, you need to see, this is all very corporate, you know, because they're all pushing each other, you know, like the hardware manufacturer have a lot of benefit with those stunts like games that push graphics to a new level, and everybody needs to buy a new graphics card, and there's more e-waste, and Microsoft and the other ones, I just know nobody says that, but they make deals in the background and they push certain technologies for other things to become obsolete, you know. And I think that's so obvious, even if you look to the migration from Windows 10 to 11, come on, don't tell me that there's no hardware manufacturers in the back over there pushing that. Yes, they are. Why you need all these technologies now, secure boot, UEFI can even understand, but secure boot and TPM manager, you only need that is to start with because they can really control you, and second of all is because that makes a lot of money for the hardware manufacturers of the motherboards, of the processors. You need now a second generation Ryzen, you need a 10th or 11th generation Intel, you know, but with the migration of Windows 7 to Windows 8, we didn't have that, or from what, 8 to 10. It runs still on a dual core, or a Cordos Duo from 2006, you know, but now they're just pushing all of that, and this is all like corporate mumbo jumbo, and you feel that you the fear of missing out, or that you need to be on the latest technology, but you actually don't, because you can grab a game that's 2 years old that still runs on DirectX 11 that just almost looks as beautiful as the latest game that come out that only run on graphics card that cost $800 with DirectX 12, you know. And so I think this is all a big corporate scam actually going on, and a planned obsolescence. And this is a reason also why, for example, I love Linux, because in Linux you can go back in hardware until the Cordos Duo era from 2006, and it still runs modern Linux of today without any TPM, without any security boot, without any how do you call that, TPM, trusted platform managers, and all that kind of garbage, or DirectX 12 graphics cards, and 8 core 16 thread CPUs that you all of a sudden need to run games that 2 years ago were almost running the same kind of games on a lot less hardware, you know. So I think that this is all a corporate How do you call that? Corporations and software companies and hardware companies coming together and sharing the same hotel room and cooking all this stuff up. And for them, that equals a lot of money, both for Microsoft and for Asus and MSI and all the graphics card manufacturers and the computer part manufacturers, you know. It just equals money, you know. So there you go. That's my opinion about that. But planned obsolescence and why many people are running games that are older than 6 years old. Well, here's your answer. Until the next time, stay safe, take care. I'll catch you in the next one.